Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class we studied multiplication by one digit numbers, correct? So today we are going to see multiplication by two digit numbers. Alright, so first we'll see how we did multiplication by one digit number. So multiplying by one digit number is very simple if you know multiplication tables. So you need to know your multiplication tables, which we had learned in the previous classes, correct? So we learned the tables from 1 to 10. So if you learn these tables perfectly, then you'll be able to do multiplication very easily. So you will have to regroup and carry over wherever the value in any place exceeds 9. So when you're multiplying, sometimes what happens? The value in a place exceeds 9. Same way in addition, whenever the value exceeds 9, how we carry over to the next place, here also will carry over to the next place. Okay, so we saw different types of multiplication. One was the box type multiplication and another was the column method. So how do we do box type multiplication? Now here we'll see it with an example. So what is 3 times 32 they have asked? So you have to multiply 32 with 3. So first we will expand 32 in tens and ones. So that is 30 and 2. So we'll write 30 and 2 like this on the box and write 3 on the other side. Now what we'll do, we'll multiply 3 with 30. Now we know that first what we'll do, we'll do 3 zeros are 0 and 3 threes are 9. So 3 into 30 is 90. Then we'll multiply 3 with 2. 3 twos are is 6. So now what you will do, you will add these results that you got, that is 90 plus 6, 96. So you will write the solution something like this. Okay, so 32 into 3 is 96. So this was box type multiplication. The column method, here you will write the numbers that you have got in columns in their respective place values as 1s and 10s. Okay, so in 1s place we will write 2 and in 10s we will write 3. Now 32 here is called the multiplicand. Okay, it is called the multiplicand, and this one digit number that is there, it's called the multiplier. So 3 here is the multiplier, and when you multiply these two numbers, the answer that you get is called the product. So now first we'll multiply the ones. 3 twos are is 6, so we'll write 6 in ones place, and 3 threes are 9, so we'll write 9 in tens place. So the product here is 96. Okay, the product is 96. Then we saw various examples on how to do multiplication by a one digit number. We saw both box type method and we also saw column method multiplication. Today we'll study how to do multiplication by two digit numbers. Okay, we'll see how to do multiplication by two digit numbers. Alright, so here first we'll study box type multiplication. Okay, so let us extend the box type multiplication to two digit multipliers. So we had used box type multiplication for one digit multiplier, now we'll use it for two digit multipliers. Here therefore I multiply 23 with 42. Now here 42 is the multiplier and 23 is the multiplicand. Okay, so we'll write 20. So first we'll write the numbers in the expanded form. So step 1 is to write the numbers in expanded form. So 23 you expand it as 20 plus 3 and we'll write it on the top of the box. And then 42 expand it as 40 plus 2 and write it at the side like this. Okay, so now first then what you'll do, you'll multiply separately the tens and the ones. So first we'll multiply 40 with 20. Now here, since you can see that they are multiples of 10, right, their numbers are ending with 0. So you'll just put two zeros, that is 1 0 from 20 and 1 0 from 40. And then we'll multiply 2 fours. How much is 2 fours? 2 fours is 8. So we'll write 8. So 40 into 20 is 800. Then we'll multiply 40 into 3. Okay, so we'll write 0. Then 3 4s are 12. So 40 into 3 is 120. Now what we'll do, we'll multiply 2 into 20. So this 0 from 20 we'll write as it is. And 2 2s are 4. So we'll write 40 here. So 20 into 2 is 40 and 2 3s is 6. Correct. So we multiply. Now what we'll do, we'll add all these answers. So 800 plus 120 plus 40 plus 6, when you add, you'll get 966. Okay, so 23 into 42 is 966. So this was box type multiplication. Now, multiplying by writing in columns. Okay, so 49 into 37. So first we'll write 49 into 37 like this, one below the other, okay, in their respective place values. Then what you'll do, first this multiplier, that is Z. So the second number is always the multiplier. Here 37 is the multiplier. So this 37 will expand it as 7 plus 30. So first we'll multiply 49 with 7. So here 7 9s is how much? It is 63. So we'll write 3 here and carry over 6 to the next place. Okay, so we'll write 3 and carry over 6. So we are carrying over 6 here. Then we'll do 7 4s. How much is 7 4s? 7 4s is 28. Now what we'll do, we'll add 6. Now we have carried over this 6, so we'll add that 6. So 28 plus 6 is 34. So 49 into 7 is 343. Okay, then what we'll do, we'll multiply 49 with 30. Now 30 in one's place has 0. So we'll in the next line in one's place we'll put 0. Then we'll multiply 49 with 3. Okay, so 3 9s is how much? 3 9s is 27. So we'll write 7 here and carry over 2 to the 10th place. Then 3 4s is 12 and 12 plus 2 is 14. So we'll put 14 here. Then we'll add these two numbers. So 3 plus 0 is 3. 4 plus 7 is 11. So write 1, carry over 1 here. Then 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 4. 8, so we'll write 8, and then here 1 is there, so we'll write 1. So 49 into 37 is 1813. Alright, so this is multiplication by writing in columns. So let's see a few more examples. Here they've told multiply 74 into 29 by using both the methods. Verify by digit sum method. Okay, so to check if your answers are correct, there is a method of verification which is called as the digit sum method. So first let's multiply, then we'll see how to do the verification. So here first, as usual in box type multiplication, split into tens and ones and find the product. So 74 you split it as 70 plus 4, and 29 we split as 20 plus 9. Okay, then we write 70 plus 4 here on the top and 20 and 9 on the side. Then we multiplied 70 with 20, we got 1400. Okay, 0 and 0 we write as it is, and 7 2s are 14. Then 20 into 4, so 2 4s are 8, and we'll follow it with 1 0. Then 9 7s are 63, and there's 1 0 after 7 in 70, so we'll put 1 0 after 63. Then 9 4s are 36, so we'll write 36 here. Now once you got all the answers, you add them. So 1400 plus 80 plus 630 plus 36 gives us 2146. Okay, so the answer is 2146. Now the column type method, as you know, first we multiply 74 with 9. So 9 4s is 36, so we write 6 here and carry over 3. Then 9 7s are 63, 63 plus 3 is 66, so we write 66 here. Okay, then we multiply 74 with 20. So we'll write 0 of 20 here in ones place and multiply 74 with 2. So when you do that, 2 4s are 8. So we'll write 8 here, and 2 7s are 14. We'll write 14. Then we add 6 plus 0 is 6. 6 plus 8, 14. So we write 4 and carry over 1. Then 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. So we write 1 and carry over 1. And 1 plus 1 is 2. So 2, 1, 4, 6. So box type multiplication and column type, both we got the same answers. Now they have also told you to do verification. So verification by digit sum method. So first what you do, first you find the digit sum of multiplicand. Multiplicand here is 74. What is the meaning of digit sum? Digit sum means you have to add the digits in that number. Okay, so 74 is a number, so we'll add 7 plus 4. Now here 7 plus 4 is 11. So we add the digits until we get a one digit number. So now we have 11 here. So we'll add 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2. Okay. Then we have digit sum of multiplier. So multiplier here is 29. So we'll add 2 plus 9, which is 11. Okay. Then we'll add 1 plus 1, which is 2. So we found the digit sum of multiplicand and digit sum of multiplier. Now we'll find the product of the digit sums. That is, we'll multiply these sums. So we'll do 2 into 2, which is 4. 2 2's are 4. Okay, then the next sum, next step is to find the digit sum of the product. Now here the product is 2146. So we have to find the digit sum of this. So what we'll do, 2 plus 1 plus 4 plus 6. So 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 4 is 7, and 7 plus 6 is 13. So we got 13. Now we'll add 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3 is 4. Correct. So the product of the digit sums and the digit sum of the product, both are 4. Both are equal. That means your answer is correct. Okay, so this is how you do multiplication with two digit multiplier and verification. Now we have 3-digit multiplicand. So we have 2-digit multipliers and 3-digit multiplicands. So here they have told find the product of 568 and 63. Okay, so 568 here is a multiplicand. Okay, and it's a 3-digit number. So first what you do, 60 plus 3. So you multiply 568 with 3. The steps are the same, just you have one extra place to multiply. Okay, so 3 8s are 24, so we write 4 and carry over 2. Then 3 6s are 18, 18 plus 2 is 20, so we write 0 here and carry over 2 to hundreds place. Then 3 5s are 15 and 15 plus 2 is 17, so 568 into 3 is 1704. Okay, then we have 6 into, we'll do 568 into 60. From the 60, we'll write 0 here in 1's place. And then we'll write 6 8's are 48. So 6 8's are 48. 8 carry over 4. Then 6 6's are 36. And we'll do 36 plus 4, which is 40. So we'll write 0 and carry over 4 here again. Okay. And then 5 6 5's are 30. And 30 plus 4 is 34. So once we finish the multiplication, we'll add. So 4 plus 0, 4. 0 plus 8, 8. 7 plus 0, 7, 1 plus 4, 5, and 3, we'll write here. So 35,784 is the answer. And then they've done verification using the digit sum method. Okay, so digit sum of multiplicand is 1, digit sum of multiplier is 9, and their product is 9 into 1, which is 9. Okay, and digit sum of the product is also 9. So it means your answer is correct. Okay, so this was how to do multiplication by two digit multipliers. Okay, so now we'll solve the problems in your textbook. So page number 132, exercise 4.3. Okay, so first they've told find the product by box type multiplication. Okay, so let's do this. Now here we have 10 into 20. So first two ones are 2, so we'll write 2. And 20 has 1 0 and 10 has 1 0. So we'll put 2 zeros after 20. So that is 200. Okay. Now we'll do 2 into 3. How much is 10 into 3. How much is 10 threes are? 10 threes are is 30. So we'll write 30 here. Then we do 7 into 20. First we'll do 7 twos are. 7 twos are is 14 and 1 0 from 20. So 140. Okay. And 7 threes are is 21. So 23 into 17 is 200 plus 30 plus 140 plus 21. So what will be the answer? Here when you add all of it, you will get something around. You'll get in 1's place we have 1, correct? And in 10's place we have 4 plus 3, 7, and 7 plus 2, 9. Okay, and in hundreds place we have 2 plus 1, 3. So the answer is 391. Okay, it is 391. Next, so we have 40 into 30 here. So how much is 40 into 30? 4 threes are is 12, and we have two zeros, so 1200 plus 40 into 5. How much is 40 into 5? 5 fours are 20, and 10 from 40, that is 200. Okay, and then 40 into 30. How much is 40 into 30? 4 threes are 12, and then we'll put 10 here, so 120, and 4 fives are is 20. Okay, so 35 into 54 will be. We'll add all that now. So 1200 plus 200 plus 120 plus 20. So when you add all that, you'll get 1540. Okay, 1540 is the answer. Now let's do the next one. So here we have 10 into 60. So how much is 10 into 60? So first 1 6 is 6, correct? And we have two zeros, so 600. Then 10 2 is how much? 10 2 is 20. Now 5 into 6, how much is 5 6? 5 6 is 30. And then we have 10 there in 60, so we'll add that 10 here. So 60 into 5 is 300. Then how much is 5 2? 5 2 is 10. Okay, so to find the answer, final answer, what you'll do, you'll add all of that. So 600 plus 300 plus 20 plus 10. Okay, so when you add all that, you'll get 600 plus 300 is 900, 920, 930. Okay, the answer is 930. So this is how you do box type multiplication. Now I want you all to do question number D and E for homework. Okay. Solve both of these questions for your homework. Okay, so do that for your homework. In the next class, we will do column method and we will do number stories in the next method. Okay, so complete your homework. I'll see you all in the next class. Thank you.